On a mission to find his missing daughter, Maura, Fred Murray went to Concord to see Governor Lynch. Frustrated with the state police investigation into her disappearance, Mr. Murray is asking the governor to release all her case files, and he'd like the FBI to get involved in the investigation.
I did meet with Mr. Murray, and I told Mr. Murray that I will look into the situation, and I promise to get back to him just as soon as I possibly can.
And we pray, O Lord, for Maura.
From the State House, Maura's family returned to where she was last seen 1 year ago.
Good. That it?
Her father replaced the ribbon that has marked the spot where Maura crashed her car on Route 112. A song written by Maura's friend is played, adding to the emotions of all that has been lost and all which remains unanswered.
I've been up here a million times. It doesn't get any easier. It just doesn't. I just hope she's well, you know, not suffering. Just want her back.
It was 1 year ago Maura packed her bags and left UMass for New Hampshire. A witness saw her walking away from the accident. Her father believes she was headed for Bartlett, but police and her family can't answer the question why. And despite numerous searches around the area, no clues have turned up where she might be. Even still, her father does not give up.
I'm completely hopeful. I mean, that's what I want. Am I realistic? I don't know, but I'm not going to stop hoping that. And I feel good every time I come out of the woods, and I've searched around. And
I did speak with state police at Troop F who are heading up this investigation. They say Maura's case remains an open, ongoing investigation that they work on every day. They say it is still classified as a missing person case because there's no evidence that a crime has been committed. In Haverhill, Chris Nielsen, WMUR News 9.